positions when they're exercising, and that they have the permission to move back to something else rather than do nothing altogether. So we're going to start by side lying. So you're just going to lie on the side. You're going to bend the bottom leg. Your top leg is extended. Your body's actually in a nice straight line. Okay, so you don't have this knee forwards. So you've got your knees in alignment. You've got this hand rolled forward. So you're rolling your body forward. So you're supporting your hand a little bit on this, your body weight a little bit on this hand. And you're just going to lift the top leg. Now, not too high, so it's not Jane Fonda style, lift the leg way up. It's just down here. So you're just lifting the leg up and down. So we start off with doing this. Now, if you're an instructor, I do around about 32 counts at least, or 64. So often I use 64 because it gives me enough time to communicate technique, what I want them to do, and what's expected. So performing about 32 or 64 counts of this. So it's just an up and down motion, not too high. And then I show them the next level. So the next level is coming up onto the elbow. So in this elbow position, and this is the important bit, is I want them to get the correct alignment, preparing for the side plank. So while they're still lifting this leg up and down, which actually will get harder, so you're gonna start feeling some fatigue in the abductors of the hip. Make sure that they're not falling into the shoulder, that the elbow is directly underneath the shoulder, and that they're lifting away. So if you're lifting away correctly, now the elbow will feel like it's a little bit too far away. Bring the elbow back in again. So they've got to start lifting up from here, so that there's a curve here, not just resting on the elbow, focusing on the leg. So the focus shifts away from this being moving to this holding up well. So you want to see that your clients can do this properly before you introduce a side plank, because this is planking anyway. There is some work here, you'll feel it for sure if you're doing it correctly. So there should be not very much effort on that shot because you're driving up from the side. So we do around about 32 to 64 counts of this, and then I add the side plank action. So they're going to hold it here while they're lifting up. Now, if you have any pelvic floor dysfunctional challenges, the first exercise clearly is fine, the one lying down. This one's good too. So just doing that exercise is going to be effective. But you may find, it sort of depends on where your dysfunction is and how bad it is, this might cause a little bit of an issue. So if it does, back off. Otherwise, it's okay. It's pelvic floor safe for some people. So it's not like you don't do it altogether. It's really dangerous. There's not a lot of downward force, but it sort of depends on your technique and if you're holding your breath or if you're forcing, pushing down because you're not familiar with the exercise, then you might need to back off until you're ready to go back into it. So lifting up here, leg up and down. Now, it's really important that your clients keep lifting up from here, so they're pulling up. Now, the load that goes through that arm needs to be directly downward, so the elbow feels like it's a little bit too far away, just inch it a little bit more. You can put the hand here to support the shoulder slightly while the leg lifts up and down. Now, at this point, you might just want to only do 32 counts because it is challenging. And the final progression for those people who really want to work hard, you're here, they're going down and up as that leg lifts up and down. This is really challenging because you're going to feel it more than just that hip or more than just here. You're also going to feel your abductors working on the opposite side to drive up. It's really important that that shoulder does not move, and it's not about the shoulder. So if they're feeling discomfort in their shoulder, it could be that they've slipped out, so they're now in this position again, and that's going to cause a lot of discomfort. Now, there is going to be some neck fatigue, so the lateral flexors of the neck are going to get fatigued for holding that hip in that position. So once you've completed doing the repetitions that you need to do on that side, and I only do 32 counts of the last two exercises I just showed you there, go back to a cross-legged position, just give the neck a little bit of a stretch, maybe even reach all the way down the side, and then swap on the other side. So about 32 to 64 count repetitions of the full lying down exercise, with that knee bent, that's good. Yep, you can definitely do that number of repetitions for this one. But once we start lifting up, you don't want to be holding this forever and seeing how long people can do it till they absolutely die. You know, exercising has to be done within the point that people get good fatigue but don't start failing with their technique. And if you're an instructor and you're a good instructor, you'll be able to read that by looking at your clients and not using your own personal ability as a way of assessing what your clients can and can't do. Okay, you're out of the equation. It's about the class, not you, and what you're getting out of it. So just be watching for signs of fatigue, and the maximum I would do would be around about 30 counts. And I find that they're starting to fatigue and fail, and they complain about shoulder pain, and that's because they just can't support themselves in that position for too much longer. Of course, if you're teaching this on a regular basis, the clients are going to get stronger, and we'll be able to do a little bit more repetition, but I would never do much more than 64 counts of any one of those exercises. So core exercise definitely works the abductors. You're going to definitely feel it in the abdominals, and as a variation of the side plank, it's a nice, interesting shift from just doing the traditional side plank. And that's this week's muscle conditioning tip.